Originally, I'm an art designer because I studied Academy of Art, Architecture and Design, Film and TV Graphics. So I studied animation, and that's why I start many years ago in my career start at short film. It's a firm where I made about 10, maybe more films, and now I continue in different studios, and so I still working in animation, except of that I am teaching at the Faculty of Art in Pilsen, close to Prague, another city, and I'm a head of Department of Animation too. So that's why my next project we are speaking about is also animation. It's something between live action animation, clay animation, different techniques and styles together. So this is my feature film project. And that's briefly all. The first inspiration, motivation was a very well known book by Gustav Meyrink. And this is a novel about golem, which appeared in 19th century in a Prague Jewish ghetto. But I was attracted by that book not because of the certain golem story, but because of the story about golem, about the Jewish town, Jewish city. So that's why the atmosphere and the characters was absolutely great, and it was my first motivation. Then we started with my colleague Edgar Budka to write the script, but we early found that it's not possible to follow exactly that story, because this is a story for live action, but animation needs a different source of maybe this more active, more dramatic in movements, in situation, and so on. So that's why we had to change our way of our ideas, and we were more focused on a ghetto in 19th century. But this is about creator, unknown creator who was sculptor, and who created a big statue of golem from a clay. And he tried to find Shem. This is another important thing what you need to make alive that statue. And he found something in old books in a library, and he used that piece of paper and put it in that clay monster. So he did. I think that now he opened a new world of clay city, of clay Prague, and this is a very enigmatic, maybe tragical, partly tragical, comical story about this culture. So this is the base of our thinking, of our script. We started very early, 87 maybe, and since that time we are looking for some producers, so it's difficult to find anybody because of the little bit different story. We didn't follow exactly this legend, and because of the expensive project. So there are many questions of my producers. Why did you decide to do that? Why? What does it mean? And so they are very, very careful and very, so they are not so happy to do that. So sometimes we were close to some producers who were excited and who were who promised us to prepare some contracts, maybe. But anyway, it stopped in a few months, maybe. So just now, this project is still sleeping. So this is our sleeping goal. But we succeeded to make a short pilot film, about 7 minutes. In fact, this is film tests, because we try to combine that live action together with clay animation and different styles. It was important mainly for me than for audience, because I wanted to try everything. So we found the right way how to do that, but now we are still waiting for producer. Of course, there are many promise, so many hopes. I met many people who were interested many times, because everybody thinks that Golem, it's a great it's a great inspiration, it's a great matter. Everybody expect that it will be about Rabbi Lev, about his clay man who was a servant in synagogue, and this is a real story about creating Golem and so on. But of course, I explained you before that we more concentrated for that for another legend which is close to that original one, and this is a legend about student who was looking for a golem in an attic of the old synagogue in Prague, and it was a dare student in 19th century, and he wrote anything from old books, and he tried to wake up Golem who found it at that synagogue, and he really found a big monster, clay monster there, and he put the piece of paper with that sham into his mouth, and he woke up. And he was growing, and suddenly he was bigger and bigger. And at the end, he fell down at that poor student. So it was the end. So this is another legend, a Prague legend. You know? So I think that our version is more close to that story. Czech animation, it's in transformation, maybe, because originally we were shooting everything on 35mm film. It was real stories by, maybe I can say that it was author films, because we were thinking about our ideas, our images. We wrote it like a script. We put it in a managing of that firm, and they said, yes, okay, this thing you can do it. But now we have to find producers, and the first questions is what is the address, or what is the address of your project? Yeah. Is it for children, adults, something in the middle? So this is a new complication, because originally it was just a film. They said, oh, you can do it. So it was for a festival, maybe for TV. And we had a distribution in Sci-Faction. There was a small room before screening, and it was a room for animated films. So that's why we had a chance to show our work in cinemas, TV, festivals. So it was quite new. This is a common question.
Yeah.
So I sometimes have to explain my students what shall we be doing after graduating their school. So of course, animation it's a technique now which is going through many disciplines, many objects, like graphic design, theater, there are, for instance, computer games, interactive animation. So there are many ways how to use animation. But I think that if you will think up some ideas and you are going to make a film, it's a little bit luxury idea, because you have to, especially short film, because short film, I said that there is no distribution for short films. So it means that there are no producers.
Yeah.
And but of course, I think that interactive animation is a big hope for young animators and for graphic design, everything. Because, for instance, my graduated students, I used to teach in Prague. They are quite successful. Some of them are, they made a computer game which is well known in the world, Machinarium. And another graduated student is successful in TV because he is doing motion design, and some of them are going back to illustration, not animation, but still drawings, and that's it. So there are some hopes, but they are a little bit different than I started many years ago.